Like, subscribe, and leave a comment. So here's your review of WWE SmackDown, the week commencing the 1st of April. And no, this is not an April Fool's joke. So it starts off with the KO show with Randy Orton and Kevin Owens. Basically, they're talking about how much they hate and disdain, have a disdain for Logan Paul. Then Logan Paul shows up on the Titantron. He's actually at the WrestleMania arena that's been built. He's there calling them out. Say, I'm here, you're there, blah, blah, blah. And then KO and Randy Orton go and find Logan Paul in the WrestleMania arena. So we'll see what happens there. Then we have the Andre the Giant Battle Royal. This is usually at WrestleMania, but for some reason they do it on SmackDown, so it's on SmackDown. So name a few of the participants in there. It was Ricochet, the OC, Angel, Berto, Bronson Reed, Indashir, Jinder Mahal, the LWO, Phantasma, Otis, Omos, who only turns up once a year, which I don't know, it's weird. Pretty Deadly, Ivar, Alpha Academy, Cedric Alexander, Creed, and the Creed Bros, and JD. The winner was Bronson Reed. So congratulations to Bronson Reed. Then we have the final testament, basically calling out the Street Profits on Bobby Lashley, saying they're going to come for a street fight at WrestleMania. I'm not sure what Bobby Lashley's and the Street Profits' name is yet. Then we have Logan Paul basically comes out to the arena, the SmackDown arena, not in the WrestleMania arena, trashes Randy Orton and KO, and basically has sent Austin Theory and Grayson Waller to go and find and apprehend Randy Orton and KO. But the plan backfires because Randy Orton and Kevin Owens are underneath the ring, and then they ambush Logan Paul. Then we have somebody in the back attacked Dragon Lee. I'm not sure who it was, but I'm sure we'll find out. Then we have Zelina versus Elektra. I think this is the Elektra's first match on SmackDown. Really good match between the two, but in the end, Elektra gets the win. Then we have, after the fight, after the match, Rey Mysterio comes down to see Zelina. Then he gets jumped by Santos and Dominic, and then they're trying to edge on Andrade to help, but Andrade actually turns on Dominic and Santos, so we'll see what happens there. Then we have Naomi and Bianca Belair come out, talk about how they're going to face the Damage Control at WrestleMania with Jade Cargill. Jade Cargill comes out, basically puts the Damage Control on notice and says she's ready and coming for him. Then we have Grayson Waller and Austin Theory versus Pete and Tyler. I think they've got a name now for the tag team, but I can't remember what it is. But in the end, Tyler gets the victory. Then we have Io Sky calling out Bayley for their match, so we'll see what happens there. Then we have LA Knight. Yeah, basically said he's coming for AJ Styles. AJ Styles is phenomenal at hiding and running away and not being found, but he's coming for him and he's going to be showing up fighting at WrestleMania. Then we have Bobby Lashley and the Street Profits calling out the final testament for their street fight on at WrestleMania, so we'll see. Then in the main event, it's Jey Uso versus Solo Yeet in a match. Really good match. It started off to be really good. It looked like Jey Uso had the victory. Then he was jumped by Jimmy Uso, which then turns into a disqualification win for Jey Uso. Then Cody Rhodes comes down. Then Seth Rollins comes down. Then it turns into a big brawl. And then Cody Rhodes says his story is going to start at WrestleMania. Let's find out what happens.